Okay, so first I wanted to say that I'm in no position to be the hub of knowledge for cognitive axes, and so don't take this video like I'm the second coming of Albert Einstein, who, by the way, is clearly a myth. And so for this video, I'm going to use my own self and my experiences as the guinea pig for this exploration of the concept of the introverted sensing, extroverted intuition axis. So what is NE like in the mind of the SI dominant? Well, nowadays I have a better relationship with this function than I do with extroverted thinking, believe it or not. And that's really due to having been exposed to extroverted intuition, having hung out with NE DOMs, and especially having known one for damn near 2 decades. But you know, let's go back to the beginning. Introverted sensing. It is the function that makes me see the world through the filter of my singular internal perception of said world. Or at least this is what I got from reading Psychological Types. I don't know, dude. I can't read German. Anyways, my singular internal perception is constantly refined and re-refined through the means of reflection and analyzation of past experiences. And I always find myself actively looking at my surroundings, experiencing events, inspecting or observing elements, social and or otherwise, and comparing them all to what has worked for me in the past. And then from there, I make a whole bunch of associations that become stubbornly there whether I like it or not. It's like constantly rearranging the furniture in my house for the ultimate feng shui. Except my house is my brain, and I just so happen to take a photo of each iteration of rearrangement. SI becomes pretty detrimental to my evolution as a person because, well, I mean, if your dominant function is oriented to one single attribute, you're inevitably going to stagnate and even decline in ever-changing situations. In my case, simply put, if this thing has worked before, it may or may not work today, and it certainly will have the possibility of being outdated at some point. So let's refine that further. Enter extroverted intuition. This is the function that, as far as I know, encompasses a view of the external world with the perception of not only what is, but more so what could be, constantly making connections between a plethora of objects. I think it also places emphasis on pragmatism and experimentation. It looks chaotic, it looks unhinged, it looks like Formula One racing on steroids. But this is exactly the thing that I feel would be most effective in going beyond where I am, and it certainly has on multiple occasions. But earlier on in my partnership with NE, if you will, it was quite, strange, to say the least. And so to bring up a diagram, here is my brain on SI. It's just chilling. It's just doing what it needs to do in the way that it feels that it needs to do it. And then here is just extroverted intuition bombarding me with questions such as, why haven't you looked at it this way? What are you going to do about it? Why haven't you done anything about it? How about we just figure out what happens as we go along? And hanging out with NE DOMs, they would ask me similar questions. And this was a source of tension within my own brain because on one hand, I hated the way that they told me this, but on the other hand, they were right. And the feelings that emerged from this internal conflict was particularly guilt and anxiety. So then one day I was like, fuck it. And then I swiveled the axis around. SI was in the passenger seat while NE ran amok, and it was like one of the weirdest days of my life. I skipped work that day. I was having conversations with strangers. I drove for like 2 hours and almost got robbed in the hood along the way. I spent like $20 on Dance Dance Revolution in the arcade. By myself, mind you. I hiked and found a waterfall. I talked to more strangers and I was hiking with them. I signed a petition for like 2 additional days to be added to every February. It was a pretty awesome day. Nowadays, I just hang out with my NE dominant friend whenever I have the time. Yeah, but anyways, these are the insights that I picked up after having put the axis back to SI and E, so to speak. Number one, utilizing NE feels like going out for a few hours, coming back, and then feeling the sudden urge to renovate my house for like the umpteenth time. I feel like SI is now accounting for all these super new possibilities and unanswered questions for consideration. In a lot of ways, SI seems to be enhanced by NE. Number two, the more I engage NE, the less I conform to the traditional label that is so often associated with SI. I feel that tried and true would become the more effective term to describe SI, especially after the SI user's exposure to NE. I would go so far as to say that the more I engage with NE, the more utilitarian and open-minded I become. Not implying that I was closed-minded in the first place, but you know, I'm just saying. Number three, I don't know, I might make a video on the NE dominant one day. Why not?